This video shows how you can debug your code while running it under the QUTest unit testing harness, both on the host computer as well as on deeply embedded targets. I will start with the usual automatic execution of QUTest unit tests to review the setup. Later, I will show you what you need to change to debug the test fixture code on the host computer. And finally, I will show you how to debug the code on an embedded board. So starting with the setup, I will use a Windows host machine and the simplest QUTest blinky example. But the general process will apply also to Linux or macOS hosts and more complex examples as well. I assume that you have downloaded and installed the QUTest collection version 6.5.1 or higher. And that you ran the QUTest installer for Windows. Which adds the QTools binary directory to the path and also defines the QTools environment variable. I also assume that you have downloaded the QPC or QPC++ real-time embedded frameworks version 6.5.1 or higher, and you installed one of them on your machine. In this video, I will use the QPC framework, but the discussion applies equally to QPC++ as well. To run the QUTest blinky example, you open a command prompt and verify your path and the definition of the QTools environment variable. Next, you need to launch the QSpy host utility to mediate the communication between the target and your test scripts. The command line option -u means that QSpy will open the UDP socket for communication with the test scripts, and -t means that QSpy will communicate with the target via TCP/IP. Next, you open another command prompt and change the directory to the QTest blinky test subdirectory. Here, you simply type make to run the provided makefile. As usual in TDD, test-driven development, the makefile both builds the test fixture on the host and automatically runs the tests written in Python. But the automatic process does not really support debugging of the code under test. The problem is twofold. First, in the standard test run, the test fixture executable is automatically launched multiple times by the test scripts, whereas for debugging, the code must be started from the debugger. And second, the test script waits for the responses from the test fixture code for a limited time only, whereas during debugging, you typically halt the execution at various breakpoints, which would cause the test scripts to time out. So the process of debugging the QTest fixture code needs to be different. Here I will use Visual Studio Community Edition to build the code for debugging instead of the command line build with MinkW compiler that is used in the automatic build. The blinky example conveniently provides a Visual Studio solution, which you can open in Visual Studio 2013 or newer. You build the code as usual, and you can set up breakpoints for debugging. For example, I set a breakpoint on the timeout transition in state off. But before you actually start debugging, you go to the command prompt and launch the makefile with special target debug. This skips the build process because the executable is already built in Visual Studio. Also, the debug target executes the test scripts in a special debug mode, in which they attach to QSpy, but don't perform target reset and instead wait for the target to connect. now, while the test script is waiting, you start the target executable from the debugger. As you can see, you hit the breakpoint in your code, while the test script patiently waits. You can continue debugging, at which point your first test finishes and the next test starts. This next test needs to reset the target, but in the debug mode it does not do this automatically, but instead it patiently waits for you to reset the code from the debugger. The code hits your breakpoint again, and when you continue this time, all tests finish successfully. One interesting aspect here is that you actually executed three tests, while you have reset the target only twice, at the very beginning and once more in the middle. As it turns out, the third test didn't wait for the target to reset and passed immediately. The question is why? Well, to understand it, you need to look at the test, which is included in the Python module test_blinky.py. When you scroll down to the third test, you can see that this is a no reset test, which means that it specifically does not reset the target. So that's why this third test didn't have to wait and finished so quickly. So this is how debugging with QUTest works on the host. The last item for this video is to show you how you can debug with QUTest on an embedded board. Well, actually, the process is quite similar and there are only two differences. First, you need to use a different development toolchain and debugger. To this end, the Blinky example provides the ARM Kyle Microvision project for the TivaC Launchpad board. To use it, you need to have Microvision installed on your machine. Here, I use the free, size-limited evaluation version. And the second difference for working with an embedded board is that you need to relaunch the QSPI host utility so that it communicates with the specific board. The QUTest test fixture for the TivaC Launchpad uses the built-in virtual COM port to communicate with QSPI. To find out the port number, you open the Windows Device Manager. You expand the Ports section, where you should see Stellaris Virtual Serial Port. You note the COM port number, which happens to be COM3 in this case, but most likely will be different on your machine. Now you go back to your QSPI command prompt, and instead of the -T option, you use -C with the COM port you found out from the device manager. Back in your Microvision project, you open the Blinky source code, which, by the way, is exactly the same as you used on the host. As before, you set a breakpoint at the timeout transition in the Blinky off state. But before starting to debug the embedded code, you need to launch the test scripts by issuing the make debug command. This step is identical as in the debugging on the host, and again, the exact same test scripts are used as well. So the test scripts start running and, as before, attach to QSPI and wait for the target. Now you can start debugging the code on the target. When the code stops at main, you continue and hit the breakpoint at the timeout transition. You continue again and notice in the script window that the test passes and the next test begins. This next test requires target reset, so it is waiting until you perform the reset from the debugger. After the reset, you hit the breakpoint again, at which point you can perform any usual debugging activities, such as inspecting variables, the registers, or the memory. Eventually, you continue, which allows the tests to finish. As you can see, the tests were not disturbed by the debugging activities, and all tests have passed. Also, the tests running in the debug mode can be skipped by pressing the Enter key. This concludes this short tutorial about debugging with QUTest. More information about the QUTest unit testing is available at statemachine.com, where you can choose the Products QUTest menu, or you can click on the QUTest unit testing harness link. Thank you for watching.